Last week at Rockingham, I still haven't come to grips with it. But we're over it. We're going to move on. I thought we still had a chance. Something got messed up with the fuel mileage, and the AI was faster than us because of the weight of the fuel in their car. I don't know. But we still had a chance. We knew a random caution was coming out, but that ended up not coming out. And we had an actual debris caution from the game ruin the race for us. Probably ruin our season. It's only the second debris caution from the game we've had. The other one was at Daytona. The second the Daytona race. So, whatever. Looking at the points now, with two races left, we're 34 points behind Gordon for the Winston Cup. And we're 26 points back in the playoffs. Terry Labonte in the lead in the playoffs. Incredible. Bill Elliott. This is going to be good. I think our best shot is still the Winston Cup. There's too many drivers there in the playoff battle for us to overcome, I think. Here's where everybody's starting. Gordon's starting third. Bill Elliott fourth. Everybody's up here. Terry Labonte 14th. We're starting 15th. As I've mentioned, we're going to start a tradition here where the second to last race of each season will set the schedule for the following season. We're only going to hit each track once, but we're going to try to get a round number. So some tracks are going to get two dates. And on the screen there are all the tracks that the 1994 season visited twice. So there's 13 tracks there, and there are five tracks that were only visited once. Watkins Glen, Sonoma, Loudon, Phoenix, and Indianapolis. So it gives us 18 races, which means we're going to randomize this three times, and the top two tracks are going to get a second date. Drum roll. That's one. That's two. That's three. So Michigan and Pocono are going to get the two extra races. And yeah, that's kind of wild that New Hampshire, Loudon only had one race in 94. So here we go. We have this set up. Here are all the tracks. You see Pocono and Michigan have been given an extra date. We're going to randomize this three times. Keep those Michigan and Pocono races apart from each other so we're not racing them back to back, you know. So we're going to hit this three times. And that's the third time. Michigan, Pocono. Pocono, Michigan. That's good. So we're going to start off at Charlotte. Oh, you know what? No, I don't want the restrictor plates back to back. Try it again. Pocono, Pocono. Michigan. Yeah, they're five or six apart. And then Talladega's up there. Daytona. Yeah, that's good. Wow. Nope, the two road courses are back-to-back down here. Can't do that one. We'll try it again. We got Michigan and Michigan far apart. Pocono and Pocono far apart. Talladega and Daytona are far apart. Watkins Glen and Sonoma are far apart. So this is our schedule for the 1994 season. 20 races, possibly the last five, Sonoma, Phoenix, Richmond, Pocono, and Rockingham are going to be the playoffs. That's wild. Atlanta will be the final race to get into the playoffs. Talladega right before the playoff cut. So that'll be interesting. And yeah, I like it. So that is our 1994 schedule. All right, I'm not going to lie. I have no idea how the end of these runs are going to work out. Do we owe ourselves something from Rockingham and the AI having an unfair advantage there? No. But we'll see. I made a couple change. I usually just try to make one change before a race, a little thing, to make it harder. But I made a couple changes here, and like I've mentioned a few times, that can just cascade throughout the AI and have big changes. They might, like, just go fly over that mountain or something. So we'll see how this goes. Had to really slow these guys down for us to even have a chance. Get ready now. Going green. There's just no way around it. But we're starting 15th, and we do have two green. We have two random cautions. Just because I've tested here a lot and I've never had a caution. I've probably run nearly three quarters of a full race here, practicing, trying to figure out this AI, and I've never had a caution. Yeah, thanks for jumping in. My name's Adam. Two races left here. Clear. Car out back. And I mean, it's just crazy that there's only two races left. Less than two races left. That's pretty cool that we set up that 1994 season. I even forget what it looks like now, but we got Michigan and I think Phoenix starting off the season. But it's just, again, if you're just jumping into this, it's just this 32 race grind. As much as fun as it's been, it's just a grind. And if it was for money, that'd be completely different. Car out back. Clear. I'd run 70 races if it was for money. Yeah, the things I had to change with this AI, there's a lot of them. I mean, this track has a road course feel to it. Because each turn, there's three turns, and each turn you have to take completely differently. So it has like a Pocono kind of deal going on. But there's just so much more, like, perfect acceleration in the turns you have to do, and braking. There's just a lot. I really had to bring down their acceleration. Coming out of turn three, they would just blow past us, and they'd be on the outside here in turn one, and they would blow past us. And I just couldn't figure it out. I turned traction and stability on, but that made it worse. Didn't try our Watkins Glen trick of using that assist, whatever, but I think that's just a one in a million thing. I am looking forward to trying that out at Sonoma in that 94 season. See if we can get faster, get more up to speed with real world. Looks like Gordon is up there in fourth-ish, maybe fifth. All right. Now, I don't know if you've noticed, and I've started picking up on it, Dale Jarrett is out in the lead. In these, a few of the last couple races, Dover, Rockingham, Dale Jarrett really took off from the field, didn't he? And I'm wondering if me upping his reliability rating or whatever affected that. Because ever since I moved that up, to where he was guaranteed not to have any more mechanical DNFs, him and Ernie Irvin, it just seems like Dale Jarrett has been running away at the beginning of some races. So that's a note I made that I want to experiment on and test. I want to experiment with the fuel thing that happened at Rockingham. I want to get rid of all NASCAR Racing Series stuff on the track, on motorhomes and stuff. So I want to get into editing the 3D. I'm not going to get into it, but There are 3DO files that you can change, so I'm going to dig into that. So even though I'm going to be quote-unquote away from the game for the next few months, I'm going to be digging in and getting that ready, getting more period correct signage on the billboards, and just watch those 94 races. Maybe Goodyear isn't on the wall right there. Look out. This is where, that wasn't me getting caught sleeping. This is where we start to lose them. There's just no getting around it. There's just no, I've tried everything to compete with these guys. Oh, that was probably the sexiest pass I've ever made. You can feel the ebb and flow in that turn under the bridge there. And you have to manage that perfectly. And as you go through the run, you have to know where your tires are at. You gotta stay off this apron here, which is tough. You have to not succumb to the temptation of running over those yellow rumble strips on this version of the track, because they slow you down. We're eventually going to hit that wall jutting out, just a matter of time. I did change the AI's wear, so they're going to pit a little bit early, because we've been pitting lap 60. They've been pitting around lap 66, and I brought those down a tad and didn't test where they were going to pit. So we'll just keep an eye on that. We also have to keep an eye on Jeff Gordon DNFing, because that's our only, that's really our only chance. We have to get near the front here and keep this a keep it a manageable, just give us a chance at Atlanta. Keep us under 40 points behind him and just hope for a miracle at Atlanta. All right, they were racing side by side, so we're on them here. I guess we weren't starting to fall. I was just being a baby and I was running bad laps, because we're with them now. But we caught them because they were side by side. Now we're going to have two rows of side by side racing here, which means they're going to catch up to us, but back behind us there. This has a Loudon feel where you get inside a car and you have to work for it for a couple laps. Until you get around them. It's not just a wham bam thank you ma'am in a turn. Doing the math in my head right now, we do not want a caution right now, so we'll probably get one. Because the AI might be able to do this in one more stop if they pit under caution. Meanwhile, we might have to go two stops. So I don't like the looks of it, but I do like how this AI is behaving. So far, I consider lap 30 to be the halfway mark of the run. As long as you manage it in turn three, they won't get into you and they won't get into us and spin us out like we've seen at a lot of tracks. I'm not really worried about turn one. Clear outside. This difficulty rating ended up being at 93. Which is just absurd. 93 coupled with some changes in the track INI file. Clear outside. There's the yellow. And we're using the fast setup. I had meant to use the Jasper setup, which would have been even faster, but I had done so much work. I thought I was on Jasper the whole time, but I was on the fast setup. So... alright, this caution, not very well timed. We're probably going to see pit stops, though. Eh, we were doing good there. We might have gotten to lap 70-ish. Yeah, everybody's definitely going in here. Bill Elliott made his way up to third. Wow. Tyler Bonney up in front of us in ninth. 45 on the speed limit here. Pretty sure everyone's pitting ahead of us here. We don't have to worry about anybody diving in front of us except for Bobby Labonte. We barely snuck in. Barely snuck into our stall. Didn't take on... in the kink, what? Alright, they messed up, but we still had a 14-8 stop. So the kink is most likely the dog leg. Alright, we're going to be going green here. Pretty sure we went in 12th and came out 12th. Jeff Gordon lost some spots. He's right there ahead of us. We banged into Bobby Labonte, but he's way up there. We got into Terry Labonte. He lost a bunch of spots. But Dale Jarrett still out in the lead. Bill Elliott still up there. Alright, yeah, him saying kink really threw me off. I had never pitted under caution here because we've never had caution. So he's never told us where the pace car is. He's never said there's a wreck in the kink because there's never a wreck. All right, here we go. All right, we get a New Hampshire-esque jump on them here. That's something to keep in mind. All right. Not sure when this second caution's gonna smack us in the face, but we gotta get to lap whatever with 65 to go. We gotta get 65 laps out of this run. An added bonus would be finishing ahead of Jeff Gordon here somehow. And I tell you what, those... because I... I'd taken a couple days off from the game after Rockingham. Again, just to reset the batteries. And, so whenever I jumped on here to hit up Phoenix, because I was running this track non-stop, really. And I didn't want that to factor into us getting a really good finish or something here. So I took a couple days off and just hit the track fresh. And those 30 laps reminded me how to run this. So that's why we're on the move right now. Alright, making a pass on Ted Musgrave. That's where we passed Benson earlier, that sexy move. So that's something to keep in mind. Bobby Hamilton giving us room here. So we'll take it. I'm in the early stages of testing the track. Turn one, I had it nailed down. Turn three was tricky. And then as it's progressed, turn three has been a strong spot. And then turn one has hurt us. Can't stay off that apron. You want to say, I mean, if you watch the AI, they stay up the track. And I just haven't gotten used to doing that. You can see, you probably could feel how we were a little late getting into the throttle on them there, because the car won't hold me otherwise. So I had to slow down their acceleration. And I'm telling you, even with some kind of ridiculous custom setup, we wouldn't be getting much faster here. All right, we have action here. Everyone's racing side by side, kinda. So we're gonna see if we can sneak in here and take a spot from Jeff Bodine. Probably not. We are going to sneak in here and try to take this from Bobby Labonte, though. Nope. Back in line we go. Yeah, we are creeping up on Jeff Bodine here. And it's so hard to pass. Again, remember I told you about not hitting those yellow rumble strips? Because they slow you down, and there you go. But it was our only chance to get around Bodine. Had to explore it. Yeah, you can see Bodine, how far up the track he is in that turn. And you can see those guys actually moving away from us up there. Awful. That's the worst I've taken turn three. Hitting that apron slows you down there in three. Not doing good right now. Yeah, we're late. We're late breaking into three. Go ahead, Ted Musgrave. We're inside. We gotta regroup. I think I'm spending my tires more this run, too. Which isn't good. I mean, we gotta get 40 or so more, about 40 more laps out of this. What would be nice is a caution. And with about 90 laps to go, which would split that race, split the rest in half, everybody would pit under that caution. And then we could get two 45 lap runs, or a 50 and a 55 and a 35 or something. Alright, we're back in it here. Oh, we got a lapper here. Coming out of the pits, he screwed us. Nowhere to go. Absolutely nowhere to go. Jeremy Mayfield exacting revenge on us from Sonoma. Now it's not the time to exact revenge. It felt like we were, I mean, this is all about track position. We were barely holding on to begin with. And now we got some work ahead of us. Alright, I mean, this is our life right now. We're just here. We've kept a pretty consistent gap between us and Kyle Petty up there. I mean, those guys behind us are 5 seconds back. Derek Cope's a couple laps down, must have pitted. Jeremy Mayfield obviously was in the pits. Came out and was really slow. And that usually doesn't happen unless they got into a wreck, maybe. I haven't looked. Because usually if they pit, I mean, we saw Lake Speed at Pocono. We've seen it a couple times where a car pits for whatever reason, and then they come out and they're fast. But Jeremy Mayfield didn't have the goods. Mark Martin in the lead here. 1.3 ahead of Dale Jarrett. Jeff Gordon worked his way up to fifth. And we need 25 more laps out of these tires. That doesn't help. Oh, what's this? What's the short straight? After the kink? We actually have a wreck. I guarantee... No, I'm not going to guarantee anything. Look where this happened, though. This is what we wanted. This is perfect. What did I say? 90 laps. We wanted a wreck. We wanted a yellow with 90 laps to go. So we're going to have two... We're going to have a 45 and a 55 run. This is perfect. This is what we wanted. Ted Musgrave is not doing okay. All right, Bobby Labonte, let's be careful. And where's Terry Labonte? He's worked his way up to right, up to wherever he was at. They're not pitting? I don't know. Not sure where the line was there. Alright, Bobby Labonte's gonna dive in there. Remember, don't pass the stop sign at the end of pit road. We gotta somehow get in here. Did he hit us? I don't know. The pace cars on the short straight. This is perfect though. Go, go, go! Yeah, we nailed that stop. Great work, guys. The pace cars in the kink. The pace cars on the back straight. Keep it under 45. I can't get over him saying kink. Oh, we gained some spots there, folks. Well, what's this? Okay. Del Jarrett has lost his mind. All right, checking out this caution. I know Mike Skinner's involved. We saw him on pit road with a banged up rear. So we're going to see what happens here. Yeah, he just slowed up. Somebody's going to hit him. Sterling Marlin will, because he was on pit road as well. And there that... Oh, Sterling Marlin's done for the day. Everyone else avoided him. And Derek Cope is a couple laps down because he took a wallop under the first round of caution. First round of pit stops under caution. And he just didn't know what planet he was on here. I think he eventually just slide. Yeah, he was messed up. Bill Elliott's on pit road. Let's see why Bill Elliott is on pit road. I saw some debris here, but I don't know what happened. Yep, Dale Jarrett nicked him, and Bill Elliott is just going to stay in the pits. There's the flash. That's not good. The flash is never good. And also, I wanted to check this out. Mark Martin never commits to pit road. It's not like he was being funny or acting weird. He just didn't pit. So, we'll see how that plays out. He's just taking a risk, I guess. He's going to do what he can. All right, we should be getting the one to go here. This is great. It's going to be 85 laps left. When we go green. All right, we're going to have some lappers. It's going to be... Cope, Skinner, and Mayfield. And they're going to be slow. Mayfield's going to be... They're all going to be slow. Cope might not be. Elliott's on the lead lap somehow. So that's good for him. Or maybe that's just... He... That was red on pit road. I don't know. But anyway, we're in 11th. Technically, we're in like 6th because of some of these cars that didn't pit. You can see up there Benson, Rudd, Shepard, and Dave Marcus. And Musgrave didn't pit, and Mark Martin up there too. They're going to have old tires. We're going to be able to swoop past these guys with these tires. There's Bill Elliott. He's going to try to get a lap back here. I guess he's a lap down. I don't know how I want to attack this. These cars down here are going to be slow. You saw that drastic move from everybody. Whoa, there's something wrong with the handling here. I got to figure this out. I think I just forgot that we were on new tires. I don't know. All right, Cal Petty. Just hold your horses. Oh, Jeff Gordon stuck behind. Whatever, on the top line. All right, slow cars are causing a ruckus up here. There's about five different, these cars have about five different speeds to them. You got the banged up cars that are going real slow. You got Mayfield going, yeah. Then you have the cars that didn't pit on old tires that are going slow. You got Ernie Irvin banging into us into one. But thankfully, we survived all that thus far. Really hugging this so Irvin doesn't give us the business. And it looks like that's Derek Cope that ran away from the world. Alright, three wide. We were three wide at Rockingham. And it didn't turn out well. Ernie Irvin's just barking right now. We're getting by Musgrave with ease because of his tire situation. We'll get by Mark Martin with ease because of his tire situation. I'm tired of seeing that big star in my rear view there. Not a smart pitch strategy. I mean, he was in the lead. And everyone behind him pitted. Now, we had that caution. I've gotten excited about, you know, the amount of laps left here. But we do have a random caution coming. Another one. Which could hurt us. I'm pretty sure the end of the run, you're only losing about a second. So it's not going to be worth a crazy short pit strategy here. And this is the track to do the short pit strategy because there aren't cautions. So, but the second random caution falling into the back half of this race, which we are officially in the second half now, kind of throws the short pitting, possible short pitting strategy out the window. Bobby Labonte making a move on Earnhardt. We're going to go with him. Or try to. Ernie Irvin will not let up back there. We don't want this three wide. We're going to go for it here. We need perfect acceleration to get past them there. We didn't get it. And I'm quote unquote diving right there because if I don't, Ernie Irvin's just going to plow into us. He is right on us and wants to go. Kind of let him go, but now we have to deal with Bobby Hamilton. And we're going to lose this to Bobby Hamilton now. Where did Gordon end up? He got stuck behind Dave Marcus on the top line, which is exactly what we wanted to see. I was excited about it. There were too much other stuff going on. He's back in 20th. Okay. I'm not sure what he has, and I'm not sure if he can pass a whole bunch of cars. It's hard to pass here. I mean, we've seen cars that are obviously faster than other cars in front of us not being able to make passes. So hopefully that's what happens with Gordon. Random caution actually hurts us in that regard. Now we're at the point where we got to worry about the random caution again. We don't want it in the next 20 laps. Do we have him here? We don't. I mean, you can see that acceleration they get is just crazy. Even when I tried to bring it down, it still hasn't been enough. Outside. Making a move on Earnhardt here. Maybe. Nope. Car's just too tight coming out of there. All right, let's not lose the big picture here. put the big picture into focus once we get on the straight here. Jeff Gordon up to 16th now. We're in 5th, so we're gaining 11 points on him. So right now we'd be 23 points back going into Atlanta. We need more than that. But 23 points, I mean, that's an entire field getting caught under the yellow, or half the field getting caught under the yellow, weird lead cars are a lap down kind of situation. 23 points if we would win in Atlanta. All right, we're hanging in here. We gotta get, 20 more laps to get halfway through this run. And knowing the AI, going a little bit past halfway when they're splitting the race, we gotta run here. Man, we surfed those rumble strips. Come on, give this to us. Stay up there, pal. Really drove it in there. Can't get him. All right, I think we're in good shape here. There's poor Dave Marcus. And I had to cut off Dale. We had to get up here. Back and forth now. We got to get around him smooth. We don't want to caution here. I bet if I just... Well, I did. I bet if I just ran this track to hell and back, we'd get really fast. We'd have the perfect marks in and out of the turns. But we just don't have it. We do have them racing side by side behind us for a while there, which was good. Just when I think, oh, I found a faster way through three. No. There's only one way. There's no shortcut. There's only one way to get through there. And sometimes I don't get it perfect. So, those cars that didn't pit, when are they pitting? Trying to do the math in my head. I don't know what that siren's for. Trying to do the math in my head on when we... What was the first pit stop? Lap 30? So... We're probably seeing pit stops with these guys soon. Not Jeremy Mayfield, because he pitted off sequence a little bit, being slow. But Morgan Shepherd, Dave Marcus, Ricky Rudd, Johnny Benson, those guys should be pitting soon because they didn't pit under that second caution. Boy. Jeremy Mayfield is slow. That car is a lap down. Jeff Gordon up to 14th. Car outside. Clear. Tell you what, we've lost that group behind us. We're rapidly catching the leaders, which I thought had to do with lap traffic. But because we're just running away from those guys behind us, I don't know what's going on. We're going to extend it even more through this turn because they're stuck behind Mayfield. Kind of risky here. Just give us the clean pass. We don't want no caution. These guys have to be pitting soon. I've got a decent little rhythm through turn three. Let's see the interval to the leader. 421. Alright, those guys are pitting now. That was Musgrave. And there's Martin. Dude, they gotta be a couple laps down. We'll check them at the line here. Yeah, a couple laps down. But on the green flag stops, they're going to gain it back, and they're going to be on fresher tires. That's going to be interesting. That too. Johnny Benson pitting. I tell you what, that actually wasn't a bad idea by them. Because what? They're basically short pitting the field. I don't know, but they lost a lot of time being on slower tires through that whole run. I don't think that was a good strategy. What did we say? We were 419 or something behind Labonte a while ago. And we're dropping fast. But yeah, they're basically pitting on sequence with everybody. But what killed them was just being on slower tires. Because we're going to be pitting here in the next... What? Oh, there was 90 to go, basically, so 50 and 40. So, lap 113, we're going to pit. And you can see we'll gain about a second per lap on them, which mathematically won't even be enough to get the lead. Unless they pit five laps later. But then they'll be on us pretty bad. I don't even know if we should short pit though. That's taking a big risk with little reward. Because we're eventually going to fall back to fourth. Where we're at now with our tire wear. And it's going to be frustrating, even. If we're on older tires by a few laps and we can't get around here as fast as the AI. Where did Rusty Wallace come from, is my question. He's for position. Came out of nowhere. I thought that was Mark Martin coming out of the pits on fresh tires, rapidly catching us. I don't like Rusty Wallace's vigor here. Yeah, we really don't have a lot to gain. There's Mark Martin. Letting him go. with those new tires on that ass. And we'll let Rusty go. So that's good. What, we pitted with 90 to go. There's 42 to go. This is basically halfway through the run. We abused our tires, so they're done. And we're going to abuse them again in this last run. But I wouldn't mind it being a 40-lap run. And they're catching up behind us now. Craven, Ricky Craven's catching us, so we're pitting. This is probably our season. If a caution comes out, we're toast.
Limit 45. Keep it under 3,500 in seconds.
Got down perfectly there. No damage.
Watch that speed now.
Four tires. Yeah, it 90 to go, everyone pitted, so they have to pit again. I'm not even sure we're going to be, I don't know, this is going to be interesting.
Go, go, go! Yeah, we nailed that stop. Great work, guys. Limit 45. Keep it under 3,500 in seconds. Okay, you're clear of pit lane.
What we want here is open track-ish. Open track with which we can use to play with our new tires. Here's Gordon. Let's not wreck him. You can really spend your tires on the outside here. That's why I'm not doing any wild moves to the outside.
Still there. Clear. Car outside. Still there.
It's not worth diving on Kyle Petty there. We can definitely, I mean, that's the sweet spot whenever they wash up the track in three on these tires. We have something cooking.
Clear outside.
I'm being gentle here too. We're not, it just feels good that we're passing guys, but everything evens out in the end time wise. All right, we got a pitter on pit road. We should be seeing a bunch of stops now.
Clear outside.
So we do want to be aware of that heading into three.
Clear outside.
I don't see anything crazy from Bobby Hamilton there.
Clear.
Although he dipped down quick, he's pitting. Okay, here we go. Tell you what, you know what we have to gain? What we have to gain from a short pit situation was getting a point for leading a lap, even though we do eventually fall back into fourth. Fourth. Before we head back into fourth.
The leader's pitting now.
Almost forgot they were pitting there. I'm be anxious to see where we end up here. We gained about a half a second per lap on fresh versus old. Looking for green car here, and there's Labonte.
Inside.
I'm not sure if we'd actually be leading the lap here anyway. It's hard to even know what's going on. We are a lap down, though. Ernie Irvin. Other than that squeal right there, because Ted Musgrave didn't know what he wanted to do with Bobby, with Brett Bodine. This may help us literally in the long run. Being kind of smooth with the tires here, navigating lap traffic, might give us the tires we need at the end of the race. We're in first. Okay, we led a lap. Bobby Labonte will be coming for us. Our next goal here is do this and try to put more cars between us and Bobby Labonte. The slower cars, the better. This is, I'm starting to feel good about this. 30 laps, that's a long time though. All right, keeping a steely eye on that Bobby Labonte interval in the bottom right. See what happens there. There was debris on the track last time we went through that, the kink in the short chute. So I'll throw up what happened there. Not exactly sure. All right, we're 247. Oh, he's catching us. I don't think we're going to be able to hold him off. Our best bet is just trying to balance going fast with saving tires, with putting these cars between us and him. This is going to get very interesting, I think. All right, the good news is, looks like Chad Little and Johnny Benson back there are fighting for position. And any side-by-side stuff's excellent in front of Bobby Labonte. As he's 2.7 back. That's definitely what happened. I mean, he gained on us that one lap. And he might be 2.8 back here now. No, he gained 600ths. I don't know. We're holding on. What's crucial here is getting through these guys clean without a caution. Still don't have that random one. It might have fell when I was looking at replays or something. All right, we just gained a bunch on Labonte. I think Chad Little and Johnny Benson Racing is everything right now. All right, they're not racing anymore. Bobby Labonte got past one of them. But that screen just said he's 3.2 back. Oh, yeah, then he is 3.2 back. Wow. Okay, we're 3.2 seconds ahead. And we need to push Rick Mast past Marcus here. Every car we can get between us and him. That's good as gold. Just gained two, he almost gained 2/10 on us that lap. This is a big. Is it, oh, we can win this. Look out. Gordon in 14th. Oh, he just gained. He's coming. We're not going to be able to hold him off. He is coming way too hard. Again, we just got to get all these cars. This is our only chance, is getting through all these cars and making it a headache for him to get through them. That random caution would be interesting right now. So I'm not sure if cars would pit or what. Alright, what's he doing? He's a straight 2.8 back. And he's not with anybody. So we're going mono a mono right now. On this next lap, we're going mono a mono, and we're going to see if he's catching us. Where's he at? 2.73. That's a decent turn three there, too. Wow. What? How did we gain? I don't know. I don't know how we just gained 6 tenths on him. That means he ran a 29.7 lap right there. Then he just gained 4 tenths back. I don't know. But I honestly, truly thought he would be in the ones right now. Coming hard. Okay, 2 tenths there. Oh boy. But I'm pretty certain these lappers here are going to get us the win. He gained 3 tenths there. We gotta go. We saw how slow we were at the end of that one run. The run before this one. And we're getting near that lap count. 3 more tenths he just gained. Oh boy. He's got to gain over 2 tenths a lap here with 10 to go to catch us. And any deviation from that number is good for us. So, and he's got to get through lappers. I think we're golden here. He's not even up to them yet. looking good. Oh no, was that Gordon? Was that Jeff Gordon? Off the track right there. That was a red car. Holy moly. No, that's the middle of the field there. I think that was Hutch Strickland. The whole season just almost flipped on its head. That was Hutch Strickland. We're six laps away from what I'm going to say is the most satisfying victory of the season. The work I put into getting this track fun to watch and to race on. The pit strategy we had to do this race. Strategy we had to do here at the end, getting past some of these cars, using up the tires strategically to get around these guys. But there's Labonte, only 2 seconds back now. If it wasn't for lappers, he would have a shot. But with 4 to go, I mean, he's got to make up a half a second a lap. And he did just make up 3/10. Let's not talk about it. We need good laps here, but we're on these dead tires, though. He's going to have to pry this from my dead hands. They won't even be cold. Okay, he didn't gain a bunch there. I can see that green car lurking in the rear view. He just doesn't have time. And we never get a random caution this late, so we probably aren't going to get it. We're at 2 to go. Come on, baby. We weren't going to be able to hold on very much longer. Jeff Gordon, Worm, crawled up to 11th. But we're going to get... Okay, one to go here. Come on, bring it home. We're going to get 49 points here. And 11th, I mean, I think it's going to be 32, I think-ish. So, coming in here, we were 34 down. We're gaining 17. we're going to be down 17 going into Atlanta. What a win. What a win this was.
You won!
Wow.
Hey, you're number one, even though you still look like number two.
Wow. We're taking this down pit road, not doing burnouts, because we're taking this car to Atlanta. Got news for you. All right, taking a look at the results. We got the win. Bobby Labonte second, obviously. Rusty Wallace was scary there for a while. Earnhardt in fifth. Terry Labonte finished top 10 after he had something go on pit road. Gordon finished 11th. Andretti and Schrader are just afterthoughts now, points-wise. Mark Martin had just weird pit strategy this race. Bill Elliott, that's the big one. Feel bad for him, whatever happened to him there. the Bill Elliott thing hurt. And Dale Jarrett finished 39th. I probably showed a replay. Something must have happened to him. And this is what we're worried about. We're 18 points behind Gordon going into the final race of the season. I was doing quick math during the race and I said 17, but we're 18 points back. Everyone else cannot win the championship. It's between me and Gordon. And then over on the left with the playoffs, we have a good shot there. We got to watch Labonte. And I mean, if we win the playoffs, we win the playoffs. Cool. But we're going for that Winston Cup. All right. I'll see you at Atlanta for the final race of the season.